So I know you're probably watching this on YouTube, but do you know about Library or BitChute? They're both competing alternatives that aim to fix the issues currently plaguing YouTube. If you don't know what I'm talking about, then stick around and watch. You'll learn something. Hey. I'm your host, Jay. This is DS Tech Media, and today we're going to be talking about Library and BitChute. And as I mentioned before, they are alternatives, or rather alternative video platforms to YouTube. And creating an alternative to YouTube is a no easy task. Hosting HD video means insane amounts of storage, and streaming HD video on demand requires torrential bandwidth that's even more expensive. Because of the infrastructure overheads, Google allegedly operates YouTube not just with no profit, but at a loss. And I say allegedly because they don't share their earnings or figures, so we don't really know exactly what they make. So with all that, how can a competing platform emerge? The top contenders are using clever decentralized architectures to get around those storage and bandwidth costs. And we're going to look at those today. There's also the issue of providing incentives to the creators who are paid on YouTube through ad revenue. So, what is the problem with YouTube? Well, there's more than one, but it boils down to censorship. Originally, YouTube banned Alex Jones for hate speech, and soon after, I think it was only channels with political, social, or racial agendas that were experiencing the community guideline strikes for certain content. But then there was the adpocalypse, where YouTube began demonetizing videos that weren't advertiser-friendly. And then it was announced that YouTube was going to adjust their algorithms to promote content that they had deemed relevant and reputable. And after the algorithm changes, I started to notice a big change in the videos, being suggested to me. Before the changes, the algorithm provided endless discovery of content related to what I already watched. The demonetization of creators is also often unpredictable now as well. One of my favorite tech journalist Brian Lunduke did a video addressing this, and at the time he claimed that simply having Linux in the title of the video would mean that the video would be automatically demonetized. So let's look at Library and BitChute. Let's start with what they have in common. They both are pro-free speech and anti-censorship. They're both using newfangled decentralized systems to operate. Both of them have mechanisms for allowing content creators to be paid for their work. Neither are powered by ads, meaning there's no pressure from brands about creators' content on the platforms. Unfortunately, neither currently have live streaming functionality. They both offer a sync feature to transfer your existing YouTube library over to their service. But what else should we know about them? So BitChute is arguably the more well-known of the two, with some of the larger YouTube creators openly embracing it. BitChute uses their decentralized BitChute uses a interesting decentralized system for their content, storage, and streaming. They claim that the entire system is distributed and decentralized using WebTorrent technology to torrent stream all of their video to the users, with each user contributing a portion of the bandwidth and a portion of the storage, just like any BitTorrent client that you may have used in the past. This, however, has been disputed because a Daily Dot researcher did some digging and noticed that all of the videos that he did forensics on seemed to lead to the same servers, but all of them were under the ownership of BitChute, presumably. Also, they have magnet links, but from what I can tell, the magnet links never actually work. So it doesn't really appear that BitChute is actually using WebTorrent to stream their content. It's not really understood why they would lie about such a thing. They do have counts on video views. You can thumb up or thumb down videos. They have playlist and favoriting, watch later. You can flag videos, of course, share, etc. and so forth. You can also tip or pledge money to the creator through this little dollar sign button here. They also have comments, but it's actually powered by Discuss is its own commenting platform. A bunch of different websites use it. So that's another account that you have to sign up for, which is kind of a drawback. Another major drawback is the resolution. They currently only support a maximum resolution of 480p, which is not even HD. However, they allegedly will be upgrading this to 720p once they reach their current funding round. I started using BitChute months ago, and I signed up for their sync program, and that is how all of my YouTube videos were moved over to here. However, since about 4, maybe 5 videos ago, sync seems to be broken. I've seen other people complaining about this. On BitChute's Twitter, they claimed that they were back up and running and that they had fixed a bunch of bugs, including sync. However, videos I've published to YouTube since then still have not synced. They don't have an official mobile app, as far as I know. There are some in the Google Play Store, but to me they seem like they're basically like a web interface app. The search functionality also has been considered somewhat lacking, but I can say that it has improved in the months since I've been using it. I don't want to seem like I'm totally bashing BitChute here. It's not a bad platform, and I do manage to get some views. Usually my videos actually do better here than they do on YouTube. Okay, let's move on to Library. So Library is a secure, open, and community-run digital marketplace. Enjoy the latest content from your favorite creators as a user, not as a product. So there's a lot of information right there. Library is open source, which is something that DS Tech Media is all about. You are not the product, which means that they're also not harvesting your data, which is pretty much Google's primary function. Library differs greatly from BitChute and YouTube. The entire platform is based on a protocol as well as LBC, which is the library credits. LBC is a cryptocurrency, or crypto token. It's available on several crypto coin exchange marketplaces. It serves as a way for the creators to be paid for their work and as a way for users to tip those creators. Library is primarily built around an application rather than a web interface, However, they, in the past couple of months, have released library.tv, which is the web interface version of Library. But as I said before, the primary way to use it is through the desktop and mobile apps, and they have mobile apps for Android and iOS available in the App Store and Google Play Store. They also support Linux, macOS, and Windows. And they also use a decentralized system. Right now, it's simple. You host what you download and publish on the Library desktop app. Hosting is not currently available on Library TV or for Android. I'm assuming iOS is also not included in the hosting part. The hosted data is stored in the LibraryNet blob files folder. On publish, content is also sent to Library in order to help rehost content so your PC does not need to remain available. So how does Library benefit content creators? Can I earn money using Library? And this is basically them explaining the Library credit system, which is basically a charge what you want platform. You of course can have all of your videos available for free, or you could set whichever price you think is correct. It says here they found a reasonable guesstimate of around $2 per 1,000 views. This works out to a penny per 5 views. You can charge just 1 penny per view, as a price any viewer could pay without a second thought. You may get 5 times the per view earnings you'd get from YouTube instantly. Furthermore, you can share content of any type: video, music, ebooks, images, podcasts, all on the same platform. And the code for the entire Library platform is hosted on GitHub. If I go here to download for Linux, they have an app image and a Debian file available. Here at the Creators tab, they have the YouTube Partner Program, and as I said before, this allows you to sync your existing YouTube channel content with your Library platform. And as far as I know, there still works. Let's go ahead and open up the desktop app. And it also puts a little icon up here in your system tray. And it actually doubles not just as your app interface for the platform, but also as your wallet for your Library credits. You can actually earn credits through their rewards program just for watching videos, and this goes up as you complete them. There's new ones that populate this list. 1 through 100 LBC for the Daily Watch, 5 LBC for earning an upgrade, claiming that right now. Like I said, just watching gets you that. You can get a bigger bonus for inviting others. So this is a way for users to get some LBC to contribute that recommended 1 penny per video. If we go over here to the settings, you've got a light and dark mode, which is always appreciated in any modern app. You can sync your preferences across devices. This sets the download directory where your videos go. And Library actually supports, I know they do at least 1080p resolution, because that's what I publish all my content in. You got network and data settings. You can set a maximum purchase price that prevents you from purchasing content over a certain cost. The safety measure. You can turn confirmations on or off. They have a very cool floating video player function, which I'll show you in a second. You can set it to autoplay media files, and they do allow mature content, and this will turn that on or off. You can block channels. They allow native desktop notifications, share diagnostic data. You can manually set the dark or light, or you can have an automatic dark mode. You can also encrypt your wallet with a custom password and hide the wallet balance in the header. There's some experimental settings for claim support. You can set your max connections. You can use custom wallet servers. You can set the types of content you want to follow here with your tags. Oh, and I should mention that there's already a large push in the Linux community specifically towards Library. So Linux is a pretty popular topic. Here is Mr. Lunduke. And the video player actually has a full screen, and you can watch as slow as a quarter speed and as fast as double speed. I want to navigate away from the video I'm watching. You have this little floating player. How awesome is that? You can also have more than one channel. I accidentally created two. And this is my library page, and all of these videos are synced from my YouTube. They also have their own integrated commenting system, and they do maintain view counts through their centralized server. And it's a really nice, really clean web interface. It even has back and forward functionality. And if you want to find me on Library, the links are always in my video descriptions, as well as a link to my BitChute. So that's the skinny, the rundown on Library and BitChute, two platforms that I definitely recommend. I honestly like both of them. Library definitely has a stronger technical foundation underneath of it, and the fact that it's open source means that I'll endorse it over anything else based on that alone, because it can be replicated if anything ever does go awry. The main drawbacks of BitChute here obviously are the lower video quality at 480, the fact that the sync seems to be broken, and the fact that they are maybe misleading people about the decentralized aspect and using the WebTorrent technology underneath of their platform. It's a little off-putting because I'm not sure why they would lie about something like that. Anyway, guys, that's gonna do it for this video. I hope you learned something. Please like, share, and subscribe. If you're on Library, please leave me a tip. I usually upload several videos a month. At the very least, I upload at least once a month. It really depends on how large the projects are. DS Tech Media is mostly about open source software and technology, but we also do gaming, hardware, and tech news. I also do tutorials about servers and overall Linux geek coding hacky stuff. Let me know what you thought about the video. I really hope you learned something here. Thank you for watching DS Tech Media, and we will see you in the next one.